I'm going to narrate my way from Bryant Park at 5th Avenue and 42nd Street to Astoria, Queens. And first thing I want to do is make sure all my lights are turned on. I've got a side light hot rod there turned on. Side light hot shot in blinking mode. That takes care of the rear. Side light dash in low mode. And warp smart horn in slow strobe mode. I got a side hot rod on my left fork and another one on my right fork. I'm turning them both on in flashing mode so I have some side visibility. Now that that's taken care of, I'm going to put my gloves on because it's cold out. The least thing you want to worry about is frozen hands. So I'm going to walk my bike across the street. Actually, no. I'll just park my bike here and wait for the light. This is 42nd Street and 5th Avenue. It's a little bit busy here today. It's getting closer to the holidays, so New York has a lot more traffic. Now I'm seeing here the box is getting a little bit congested. I may have to go around these vehicles, which I don't have to. I'm just going to maintain my lane here in the bus lane. I'm looking in my mirror to my left, and it's clear, so I'm going to take this lane here. I'm also wearing a reflective vest and also using a mirror. That car just made a turn without looking. Thankfully, the driver stopped. And I'm just going to maintain my position here behind this Toyota Corolla. I could take the bus lane to my right, but I'd rather maintain position because over there there's obstructions for cars parked in that lane. Staying in the left tire track is preferable because you don't want any cars to overtake you within inches. Now here's Grand Central, it gets a little congested, the car to my left, let him pass, goes to the side away from the door so there's no danger from any unwanted door prizes, and continue maintaining position. So here it's a little bit backed up, I want to filter through the middle, there's less chance of getting doored here. Slowly gonna make my way to the right, staying away from these cars. Just slowly look here into these windows so you know if there's a risk of getting doored or not. And I'm at the front now. Signal just went, so the light's almost about to change. And I'm going to stay in this bus lane because I don't want this taxi to go ahead. They got plenty of room to overtake me here. Make a left, left turn signal. Taking this lane here. Staying right in the middle. Traffic's backed up. Just going to the right here because this car's speeding up behind me. Let him go. I know a lot of people say to always take the lane, but in my experience, that doesn't really work too well in New York. It makes drivers more angry. And it encourages road rage and close calls. Okay, I'm gonna move over to the right, let this car go ahead. See, my mirror is clear, left turn signal is out. Taking the lane, maintaining position. First Avenue, so I'm just gonna get off my bike and walk my way across the intersection. Let this tour bus go through. All right, so I'm clear. Getting back on my bike and we're good. There's a little bit of a hole here with a dip, so just be careful not to get in down there. Getting off my bike and walking across. Illegal, but no one here to enforce it. No one cares about jaywalking in New York City. Now here is just a little bit dark, so you have to keep an eye out on the road just a little bit more carefully than during the daytime. There's a government vehicle parked in the buffer zone. This taxi needs to yield to me and I see them slowing down. Just do a little head movement to make sure they're there. The bike lane's closed, so just be a little bit slow going past you because it's a little bit close to these parked cars. Here, just ring my bell, let them know. Here, the bike lane is in the middle. I want to maintain my position here, so I'm not all the way in the left turn lane. Here's a stop sign coming up. The bike lane goes onto the curb here, goes back out here. Go into that catch basin to my left there before. Here's a cyclist going the wrong way, so I'm gonna stay to my left, do it early so they don't make any sudden movements. Turn lane with this hazards on. I don't know why. Now they're moving. protected bike lane is usually pretty good. Here the bicycles have a green light and these cars have a flashing yellow, which means they have to yield. So I'm just going to take it really slow. Let this taxi go. And then I go. I could have went, but I don't trust my life in the hands of that taxi driver. Better to just take it slow and let them go. It's only going to cost you like half a second anyway. To me, that's not worth an injury or a trip to the hospital. Sometimes you just gotta let things be. Here ignore this sign, I mean this signal and cross anyway, but that's an unwise move to do. That, my friend, is New York City in a nutshell. two-way bicycle lane here. Not sure what that is all about, but cops are on to something. I want to signal a left turn here. It's pretty dark here, so you have to take it really, really steady and be vigilant. Two-way bike lane. Don't have your lights on too bright, or it may cause a safety hazard for the person coming the opposite direction. If it's too bright and it blinds their view, they may not be able to see people behind you, and it will distract their coordination. This part of the bridge is always really dark. They should really have some lights here, but usually there aren't too many like hazards over here, broken glass or dirt, so it's safe. Starbucks company. I just avoided that hazard. too risky to stay all the way to the right like that. And maybe some broken glass or pebbles or other something that may catch your tire and make you lose control. Plus, there's a lot of space on this pathway for other cyclists to come up. This section of the bridge is always a little bit dark for some reason. Every once in a while I'll take a quick peek behind me to see who's come down. I shouldn't really be passing cyclists at this speed anyway, at the speed I'm going. Bike lane, but easily can be solved by going around it. There's no other traffic. There's some little dips and imperfections in the bike lane here, but what are you gonna do? These barricades are a little bit protruding into the bike lane, but it's not too bad. A little bit. Let me see if I can push it in. All right, good. Thank you. block coming up, it's completely dark. The city never fixed the lamp here. So what I do is I'm going to turn my cycle light dash front light and put it into super boost mode so I can at least see some of the road. It's not bright enough to light up the whole road, but it's enough. Alright, I'm past that section now. I'm turning it back to low. Now this block in Astoria has some little tiny bumps in the bike lane that are hard to spot. I'll show you one coming up. Right here. And right here. They're not that horrible, but it's enough to give you a little bit of a shake if you go in there without knowing they're there. Vehicle is making a left, so let the driver go. Staying on the right side of the bike lane to allow ample reaction time for any unexpected doors or people walking out. Astoria.